unbeaten to this point in his career, but ready today to step up in class and face by far the most dangerous opponent he will have met so far, Roger Mayweather. And lest there be any doubt about hostilities between the two, we take a look back at this scene from last night's pre-fight physical examination. Whitaker, having just been examined by the doctor, prepared to step up from the chair and surrender it to Mayweather. Mayweather, stepping in from behind, began to talk to Whitaker. And in a few seconds, push came to shove as Whitaker lashed out with a shot to Mayweather's chest. Mayweather attempted to retaliate. The stage is set for this 12-round North American Boxing Federation lightweight bout between that man, Roger Mayweather, and Pernell Whitaker, live today from Norfolk, Virginia, on ABC.
Fifth time in his professional career, Pernell Whitaker is fighting in his own hometown. This will be a certain advantage.
Well, of course, Becky, it is the standard, highly partisan, extremely raucous Norfolk Scope crowd entirely behind Pernell Whitaker, and Whitaker now coming into the ring. But all of this crowd's enthusiasm may not be enough for Whitaker today as he gets ready to prepare by far the toughest opponent in his so far brief professional career. Hello again, I'm Jim Lampley. With me now, our boxing expert Alex Wallow. And Alex, first of all, what do you make to this point of the 11-0 record of Pernell Whitaker?
Jim, it's tough and perhaps a little bit unfair to criticize a fighter who's won virtually every round of the 11 fights he's had in his pro career to date. But the fact is that after a sensational beginning, Pernell Whitaker first broke an ankle, and then a year ago this month, he broke his left hand. And in the three fights since, he has not recaptured his early form. His handlers hope that the challenge presented by a world-class fighter like Roger Mayweather will bring out the best in Pernell. One thing is clear. He will have to show a big improvement over his recent performances, or he will leave the ring today with his first loss.
Well, that's an interesting prediction, because Mayweather has been up a one-time world champion as a junior lightweight, but he's also been knocked out a few times. Which one will enter the ring today?
Jim, we won't know until the fight starts, of course. But his handlers, Mayweather's handlers, are very, very confident about this fight. In fact, his manager, Billy Baxter, a Las Vegas professional gambler, says he's wagered $125,000 on his man. The fact is that Roger Mayweather feels in his mind that the reason for his early losses were, number one, his struggle to make the 130-pound weight, and number two, the fact that he had terrible training habits. Now he's more comfortable at 135 pounds, and he says he's in the best shape of his life.
Now, bettors favor Whitaker in this fight by 5-2 odds. You suggest that you see it just the opposite way around. What'll Pernell have to do to beat Roger Mayweather?
Well, they're very similar in many, many ways. Both are very good boxers, both have outstanding speed, both have a tendency to showboat a lot. I think Pernell Whitaker has the edge in defensive skill and in the ability to take a punch, and perhaps in stamina and physical strength. Mayweather has superior size. He hits harder with his power hand, the right, and most importantly, he has the edge in experience. If Pernell Whitaker beats a well-conditioned Roger Mayweather with only 11 pro fights under his belt, in my mind, that'll be an upset.
All right, let's very quickly take a look at the tail of the tape, which reveals two fascinating facts. Whitaker comes in at 134¼ pounds, the lightest weight he has carried into the ring yet in his professional career. This despite the fact that his handlers say he has added muscle bulk since his last appearance on Wide World of Sports 4 months ago. Mayweather, on the other hand, has a 2-inch height advantage and a nearly 7-inch reach advantage over Pernell Whitaker. North American Boxing Federation rules this is a 12-round fight, scoring on the 10-point must system by three judges with a non-scoring referee. Three knockdown rule is in effect. There is no standing 8 count. The referee is Chris Wallison from Erie, Pennsylvania, and Pernell Whitaker comes out throwing the right jab. Of course, we remind you, he is a southpaw. Mayweather, a conventional right-handed fighter.
Here's the right-hand counter by Mayweather. His power punch. He feels, Roger Mayweather does, that he can outbox Pernell Whitaker, but he doesn't want to do it. He wants to knock him out. Problem with that is he's subject to counter punches himself. You saw Pernell's left come right in on his chin on that punch.
Indeed, this fight could go a number of different ways. That will be called a slip by Wallace. A number of different ways because Mayweather does have knockout power and a questionable chin.
Ooh. less formidable opposition, Pernell Whitaker has not been able to knock out an opponent in his last four fights. Does he have the power to take advantage of Mayweather's questionable chin?
Now, Pernell Whitaker's handlers, particularly trainer George Benton, want him to be in close where Mayweather cannot develop the range to put the power in the right hand. But right now, it doesn't appear to me, Alex, that Pernell is up close and forcing the action in the way that his handlers may have wanted.
He has to find a way to get inside. Pernell Whitaker slips punches very, very well. He has to slip the punch and then let his own hands go. Good body punch, good straight left to the stomach of Mayweather by Whitaker. Another one. And that will take away Mayweather's legs and it'll take away some of his energy as the fight develops, if it develops into the later rounds.
Mayweather had difficulty making the 135-pound weight limit this morning. It took him more than 1 hour to get on the scales and tip under 135 pounds. It remains to be seen, of course, whether or not that took anything out of him.
Another left by Whitaker to Mayweather's body. Both fighters throwing hard punches and landing them.
Just at this early stage, Alex, it appears to me that Whitaker has more snap in his punches than he did 4 months ago against Alfredo Lane in this same arena.
Pernell Whitaker's very, very competitive, and he knows that he hasn't been that impressive in recent fights. And perhaps he will rise to the challenge, as both Lou Duva and... Good right hook, and he's down!
Down goes Mayweather. And immediately you see Mayweather's Achilles heel. This is all after the bell.
And Mayweather went to the wrong corner. Jesse Reed, his trainer, comes over to get him. He's knocked him down in round one.
You see George Benton talking to Pernell Whitaker here now. A look at the knockdown.
Watch Mayweather miss and Whitaker come up firing with a right hook. Ducked under a punch. The left put him down, but it was the right hook that started him.
In his career, Mayweather has been a first-round knockout victim at the hands of Rocky Lockridge.
Down four times in his career. He's been hurt numerous other times. The question is, with superior conditioning, will he be able to come back?
Round two begins.
Just missed, but it scored. And meanwhile, Mayweather is not scoring.
Whitaker set all this up by working well to the body in the first 2 minutes of round one.
He throws that left jab for another countering right hook by Whitaker.
But for the moment, it appears that Roger Mayweather is going to get out of round two, which is farther than he got against Rocky Lockridge or Julio Cesar Chavez, and farther than it looked for a few moments as though he would make it today. He returned for the start of round three. Briefly, let's look at the left hook from round two that hit referee Chris Wallison right in the kisser. And now the two fighters meet again at the center of the ring and begin the action in round three. Clearly, Pernell Whitaker has won both of the first two rounds. Of course, he knocked Mayweather down in round one, also scored several telling blows after the bell, which ended round one.
So from that replay, the referee takes a punch very well. He must be in superior condition.
Well, in all of Pete's previous fights here, the referee was Al Rothenberg. I don't think he could have taken that punch.
They settled down a little bit here, fighting on the inside. Obviously, that favors Whitaker. Mayweather has not used his superior size to land punches from the outside. Low blow by Whitaker. Nothing from the referee that I saw.
Mayweather seems to have his senses back, though.
He's not 100% yet. Pete Whitaker looks like, to me, like he's setting a trap. He's backing up. He's trying to draw Mayweather in to drill one of those straight left hands home. He might be better advised to do what he just did, to try to back up Mayweather. I think Roger's much more dangerous when he's coming forward, when he can plant that back foot, that right foot, and let that right hand go with leverage and power.
Good hold, Roger. Good hold. Both of you.
Say this is a very different Pernell Whitaker than the man we saw 4 months ago against Alfredo Lane.
He certainly was in round one. He's pacing himself a little bit more right here. You get the sense that he may explode.
Let him go, Roger.
But it's possible also that he let Mayweather off the hook a little bit in round two. Good right uppercut by Whitaker. Mayweather right now just doesn't have any real zip. His legs or his punches.
Indeed, he is pawing with the punches. Good left uppercut from Whitaker.
And Whitaker's going to dominate on the inside. He's just a better inside fighter than Mayweather.
Crowd getting ready to erupt again.
Oh, good solid right hand by Mayweather that had no effect that I could see on Pernell Whitaker.
Whitaker round. Beginning of round four, the scope in Norfolk, Virginia, Pernell Whitaker against Roger Mayweather for the North American Boxing Federation lightweight champion. Both of them aiming to become contenders for world championships in the crowded lightweight division. The first three rounds, all of them clearly won by Whitaker, who knocked Mayweather down in round one. Now Mayweather in the black trunks tries to steady himself and come back.
Landed another right hook up high on the head of Roger Mayweather. Crowd chanting Pete, Pernell Whitaker's other nickname, along with Sweet Pete. Left hand to the body by Mayweather, and a good cracking right hand. Best punch he's landed since the knockdown.
I got you, let him out.
And a backhand.
I got you.
First bit of showboating we've seen from Pernell Whitaker. I think Lou Duva and George Benton in Purnell's corner will allow him that bit of showboating with all the things he's done right here in the early rounds.
Roger Mayweather now trying to load up the right hand to see if he can land the one punch that might turn this fight around.
I don't think he's going to beat Purnell Whitaker loading up one punch. He's going to have to work much more with that left jab. Keep Purnell on the end of the jab. Try to get him lunging to come in. Use his height and reach advantage. Try to get Purnell lunging and then catch him with the right coming in. You always do more damage when you catch a man coming in.
Mayweather seems to be able to land a punch or two on the inside exchanges, but Whitaker doubles up and more than matches him. Whenever they are close together, chest to chest, Whitaker dominates the action. Remember to stay with us following the conclusion of this fight, as we will air for the first time ever on over-the-air network television, the Marvin Hagler versus Thomas Hearns fight, which was regarded as one of the best of all time. Marvelous Marvin Hagler, of course. For a moment there, you looked at the ring from the point of view of Lou Duva, co-manager of Purnell Whitaker.
And from that point of view, they must like everything they're seeing right now. The only quarrel they might have is that Pete didn't follow up quick enough in round two when he had his man hurt. And although Roger Mayweather is not yet back in this fight, he still is a force to be reckoned with, and I think he still is dangerous if that conditioning that he worked so hard on for this fight allows him to get a second win.
Round four coming to a close. By far the best so far for Mayweather. Whitaker back to the beginning of round five in the Scope in Norfolk, in a fight in which all three men in the ring have taken some punishment, including referee Chris Wallison, who was punched on the kisser by Purnell Whitaker during a break in round two. By far the man who's taken the most punishment is Roger Mayweather.
And in the corner in between rounds, his trainer, Jesse Reed, said, Roger, you better start doing it. You're giving these rounds away. Show me what you can do just the way you did in the gymnasium, which I believe was a reference to the fact that Roger Mayweather, in his 2.5 months of training in Houston at the HBA gym, sparred at least a week with Hector Macho Camacho, a pretty fair left-handed fighter. According to all the reports, he handled Camacho very, very easily. In fact, on one day, had him in trouble. Those are reports. But he has not shown that same kind of fire in the ring today.
Step back.
Obviously, that right hook and then the following left in round one has taken some of that fire out of him.
On the other hand, trainer George Benton in Purnell Whitaker's corner asked him to show him more uppercuts on the inside. Come up with the punches, he said, because Mayweather is leaning over on you.
Here's Billy Baxter, Roger Mayweather's manager. We talked earlier about his bet of $125,000 he said he made on his fighter.
Almost went out the window in round one.
Many more punches like that will go out the window right here in round five. Mayweather started this round quick, but he has not been able to sustain the pace. Jim mentioned at the top of the show the fact that Mayweather had to lose a half a pound at the weigh-in this morning to make the 135-pound limit. That could take some of the stamina away, and Roger Mayweather has never had great stamina to begin with.
And he has been rocked again twice here in round five. Does not look steady on his feet.
Before this fight, both men said they wanted to establish their dominance very early. They wanted to show who was the boss. Whitaker did that in round one, and he has been able to maintain that dominance, except for a few punches throughout the fight to this point.
Indeed, Jesse Reed said to Mayweather in the corner between rounds, you have lost every round, you are losing this fight, and you had better turn it around now. But nothing of the sort has happened here.
Here in the closing seconds of round five, I think Purnell Whitaker, for the first time in the fight, is a little bit tired. Obviously, Mayweather is. Purnell's mouth is a little bit open, and he's trying to get wind right now. If he's in the shape that he thinks he is, he will get his second wind as well.
But to this stage, it has been the most impressive showing of Whitaker's career.
Stop!
We are back to the beginning of round six, and what you just saw is a replay of something which took place at the end of round five, as Pernell Whitaker, who landed a flurry of punches after the bell at the end of round one, landed another blow after the bell at the end of round five, whereupon Jesse Reed, Roger Mayweather's trainer, went to referee Chris Wallison to ask him the obvious question, why aren't you doing anything about this?
And Wallison pointedly ignored him and did not warn either fighter, did not go over the corner between rounds and say, hey, fellas, knock it off. When the bell sounds, stop punching. I should point out, at the end of round five, both fighters threw punches after the bell.
We want to remind our stations along the line that we will be going to a local station break at the end of this round. Local station break coming up in about 2 minutes.
Pernell Whitaker started this round working again to the body. Good right hand by Mayweather. No effect again on Whitaker. Another good body shot, first by Mayweather and then by Whitaker. And Whitaker finished upstairs.
According to our unofficial scorecard, Pernell Whitaker has won every round on the 10-point must system. The first round, a 10-8 round. There was a left hand to the chest, which brought oohs and ahs from the crowd.
Watch what happens on this infighting. Pernell Whitaker does not stand up and then punch. He comes up punching. He comes up firing. If he just stood up and then let his hands go, he would be susceptible to punches. But he comes up winging and is landing a big number of punches. Evander Holyfield, you saw it just then in the inset. Cruiserweight champion. Won it last year, perhaps the fight of the year against Dwight Muhammad Cowie. Holding and hitting there by Mayweather.
Holyfield, of course, was the Olympic bronze medalist as a light heavyweight, friend and teammate of Whitaker's.
Mayweather missing badly and Whitaker responding. Both fighters trading bombs right there.
30 seconds to go in round six.
This has turned into a war of attrition, Jim. We said at the top of the show we thought Pernell Whitaker had the superior strength and stamina. I think that knockdown also now took a lot out of Mayweather.
10 seconds to go in round six. Mayweather still apparently not ready to show full recovery from the beating he took early in this fight. Wide World will return. We are back in Norfolk, Virginia. Jim Lapley with Alex Wallow at ringside for this North American Boxing Federation lightweight championship fight between 1984 Olympic lightweight gold medalist Pernell Whitaker in the red trunks and Roger Mayweather in the black trunks. A fight in which Pernell Whitaker has dominated from the outset. He knocked Mayweather down in round one. Hurt him again in round two. And has won every round on our unofficial scorecard.
In Whitaker's corner in between rounds, he came back and flopped on his stool. He was tired in that round six. And George Benton, his co-trainer, told him, don't worry about it, you'll get it back. Work to the body. Jesse Reed told his fighter the same thing in his corner. Both fighters have been headhunters. They've worked almost primarily to the head. I think that's one problem why Pernell Whitaker has not been as effective. Here in this fight, look, he's wearing him down. He has his man hurt.
And he hurt him once again with body punches, just as he did in round one before he began to land the heavy blows to the head. This has been an impressive performance by Whitaker, who had been criticized by some after his route-going victories in his four most recent fights.
Did you see right there evidence of how tired Pernell Whitaker is? He had his man ready to go down. Roger Mayweather was, another low blow by Whitaker. Roger Mayweather was one or two good crisp punches from going down, and yet Pernell Whitaker let him get away. He just right now does not have the energy to pursue him.
Referee Chris Wallison is apparently shy about warning fighters for low blows. There was another one by Whittaker.
He may still be trying to recover from that left hook.
In case you joined us late, Wallison himself, the referee, took a left hook from Pernell Whittaker in round two. Something like that left hook.
In any war of attrition, the crucial factor is conditioning, physical strength. Both fighters have done a lot of work with weights. They've taken advantage of all the advances in modern sports medicine to try to get themselves in peak condition, and it's just a matter of who is the most successful.
And so far, it has been Whittaker. Round seven, another big round for him in a fight he's dominated. We are back at the Norfolk Scope, and during the period between rounds, Jesse Reed berated his fighter, Roger Mayweather, in the corner, asking him, do you want to work for 3 months as hard as you did and just lay in there and look like a dead man? That's what you've done so far. Mayweather may not have enough left in his body at this point to respond to Jesse's urges.
I think he might find some inspiration, Jim, if he could listen into the Whittaker corner in between rounds, because they're trying to keep Pete's spirits up. He is tired. I think he's put on a very good act in not letting Mayweather know exactly how tired he is. Good sharp right hand by Whittaker. Did not land flush, but it got Mayweather's attention.
This is round eight of a 12-round fight.
Billy Baxter over in Mayweather's corner is an outstanding poker player, good enough to have won the World Series of Poker on two occasions. He must be admiring of Whittaker's poker face in not revealing how dead tired he is right now at this point. You're looking there at Eddie Aliano and Jesse Reed in the corner. In the background there, sitting down, Billy Baxter. Again, Roger Mayweather. Roger Mayweather, nothing in response. Letting Whittaker get off first. And letting Whittaker dictate the pace.
Once again, we remind you at the conclusion of this live match from Norfolk, we will show you for the first time ever on over-the-air network television tape of the Hagler-Hearns War in Las Vegas. And Alex Waller will have a live interview with marvelous Marvin Hagler as we look ahead to Hagler-Leonard on April 6th.
He's gutting it out. He is tired. They're both tired. But Whittaker is just finding something inside of him that gives him the ability to let his hands go more often. And the thing I'm impressed about, Jim, is that Pernell has been so much more accurate in this fight. In his last three fights against much lesser opponents, he missed more punches than he landed. He's still missing punches here. Nobody lands every one of them. But he's more accurate against Roger Mayweather in a situation where he should also be, he has to be more defensive-minded because Mayweather has more to counter with.
20 seconds left in round eight of a fight in which Pernell Whittaker very badly wanted to reestablish his credentials as a rising contender in the crowded lightweight division. So far, he's well on his way to doing exactly that. Round nine begins, and Roger Mayweather tries to begin to deliver some punishment for the first time in the bout to Pernell Whittaker.
Roger Mayweather lost a half pound at the weigh-in. If he doesn't watch it, he's going to lose his trunks here in the fight. They're well down below his cup. This referee is just not on top of things. He should call time and pull up his trunks.
The trunks are soaked with perspiration. In addition, Mayweather has taken several low blows for which referee Chris Wallison has not warned Pernell Whittaker.
Calling time. Pernell Whittaker pulled out his trucks there.
This is funny.
As soon as Mayweather tried to pull down his truck stop, Pete Whitaker did exactly what he should do. He jumped right on him.
Now Jesse Reed goes to work on Mayweather's trunks. As Whitaker gets a breather, so does Mayweather. It can't hurt either fighter. Brunell Whitaker communicates with Alex Wallow at ringside. What is he saying, Alex?
I just asked him how his hand was. And he's still gesturing to me. He says that I thought he wasn't using his left enough. And I pointed my left hand to see how it was, the hand that he injured. And he shook his head. And then he touched his head like he hurt it. He might have hurt his left hand landing it on the top of Roger Mayweather's head. Take a look and see how often Brunell Whitaker uses his left hand.
Of course, you will recall that he broke the hand 1 year ago in a bout here with John Montez across the river in Hampton.
He threw it there, but missed it.
Oh, a booming right hand.
And he's hurt.
And Whitaker's hurt.
And he hits him while he's down.
Two, three, four.
Brunell Whitaker was hurt and went down, and Roger Mayweather clearly hit him when he was down.
Brunell's still groggy. Mayweather stepped back in.
I'll tell you something. Pete is still groggy. He's still hurt. His legs are not there. And Roger Mayweather was motivated by the humiliation of that move by Brunell Whitaker and pulling his trunks down. He came out of his corner an angry young man. And he's still angry. And Brunell Whitaker is still not in great shape. His head looks fine, but his legs are still not great. Mayweather trying to land the perfect right hand. He should be letting his hands go.
Mayweather is very dangerous with the right hand. 27 seconds to go in the round as Mayweather stalks Brunell Whitaker.
And Whitaker effectively, Mayweather's not throwing punches. He's just not shooting his hand. As badly hurt as Whitaker is, he has been able to nullify any potential by Mayweather by a little bit of movement.
10 seconds to go in the round. Whitaker is going to last it out, apparently. Fireworks in round. We're back in Norfolk, and we may have a brand new fight as a result of this sudden turn of events in round 9. You saw there the devastating right hand of the jaw thrown by Roger Mayweather. Brunell Whitaker went down after having won all 8 previous rounds and having downed Mayweather himself in round 1. Now with 3 rounds to go in this 12-round bout, it remains to be seen who has more ammunition to finish with.
What you didn't see in that replay was that Roger Mayweather, a full second at least after Whitaker was down, threw a punch at him while he was on the deck. Again, nothing from the referee, and a good right hand by Mayweather. On our scorecards, Jim, he has to stop him in these last 3 rounds in order to win the fight.
Indeed, that is the case. Whitaker, it would appear, if he can hang on and stand up through the rest of the bout, has already got it won.
If Brunell Whitaker's left hand is hurting him, he's going to have to use it. Previous round, there's Whitaker on the deck, and there's Mayweather hitting him clearly after he's down.
Remember that that sequence took place about 30 seconds after the conclusion of a sequence in which Mayweather had lost his trunks. They had slipped down around his thighs, and Whitaker had reached out and pulled him down farther.
And believe me, that was a motivating factor. Mayweather got a little bit of rest while the trunks were pulled up and attached with tape. But he also got very, very angry. It really lit a spark in him.
And it was a fight in which Whitaker had appeared angry from the outset, attacking Mayweather with fury in round 1. Now we've got less than a minute to go in round 10. Both fighters have looked a little tired in this stanza.
Looks to me that for the time being, that blow almost hit Roger Mayweather in his knee by Pete Whitaker. There's Billy Baxter, Mayweather's manager, holding and hitting. Took 3 of them for the referee to step in. Referee said, if you do it again, you lose a point.
Another low blow from Whitaker. Wallison has said nothing about them. Billy Baxter, Mayweather's manager, has a $125,000 bet on his fighter today. And he needs a knockout.
In this round 10, Roger Mayweather has not been able to follow up the advantage that that right hand gave him in round 9.
We'll be back for the last two rounds. Round 11 begins in Norfolk, Virginia, as Pernell Whitaker tries to close out what will be the most significant victory of his 12-bout professional career. Round 10 was the first relatively even round of the bout.
Mayweather, a little bit more fire here. Good right to the body a few seconds ago.
In case you've just joined us, Mayweather needs a knockout.
Unofficially on our scorecard. Forcing the action, Roger Mayweather. But there's Whitaker firing that left hand. Mayweather is wobbly. Pernell Whitaker has never been past the 10th round. Roger Mayweather has been 12 only once. So he looked over at him and said, I'm all right. Mayweather may know that he has to score a knockout to win, and may feel that his only chance of that is to entice Whitaker into charging in and to catch him coming in.
Now let me warn our local stations, if both fighters are still standing at the end of this round, it is our present intention to give you a station break. Obviously, that could change in the next minute. But for the moment, we're looking for a station break after this round.
Roger Mayweather may have been acting, but he just looked over in his corner. He's a tired fighter.
51 seconds to go in round 11.
I guess that's pretty obvious that he's a tired fighter. Both men are.
Crowd on its feet in the scope, expecting something to happen any second. Mayweather with his hands down.
Baxter is a professional gambler from Las Vegas, an outstanding poker player. He said says that he bet $125,000 on his fighter. That's how sure he was going to dominate Pernell Whitaker. It's not that Roger Mayweather has been bad. It's that Whitaker, I think, has been very good, Jim.
We'll have a station break at the end of this round, and prior to a decision, if both fighters are still standing at the end of round 12, we remind you, tape of Hearns Hagler, first time ever on over-the-air network television, coming up later in ABC's Wide World of Sports. Alex Wallow, a live interview with Marvelous Marvin Hagler, who no doubt is watching this action right now. Less than 2 minutes to go in the fight.
Roger Mayweather, you may think he's not trying because he's standing there posing, but actually he knows he wants Whitaker to come to him. He wants to throw that right hand. That's all he wants. He's just looking for a spot to shoot that right.
Whitaker knows the same thing. It would be sufficient now for Whitaker to simply dance out the last minute.
Great clean. I got you.
He's still throwing punches.
Tremendous experience, learning experience for Pernell, and will go a long ways to proving to himself as well as to the rest of us that he has what it takes to be a world champion.
And he's giving it a rousing finish. That's it.
And this crowd in Norfolk, it is a habit in Mexican towns and in towns of Mexico. There are coins coming into the ring.
ABC's Wide World of Sports will return for a decision in the Whitaker-Mayweather fight after this message from your station. All right, we are back live in the Scope in Norfolk, Virginia, where Pernell Whitaker, the 1984 Olympic lightweight gold medalist, blows kisses to his fans after a rousing 12-round performance against the very dangerous Roger Mayweather in a bout for the North American Boxing Federation lightweight title. And now ring announcer Bruce Rader with the decision.
Judge number one scores 116 to 110. Judge number two scores 117 to 111. Judge number three scores 116 to 112. The winner by a unanimous decision from Norfolk, Virginia, Pernell Whitaker.
Whitaker wins his first title of any kind and moves to 12-0 as a professional, stepping into title contention in the crowded lightweight division. Roger Mayweather drops to 26-5, and it is an open question at this moment where his career will go from here. It was a fight in which, as the judges' scorecards demonstrated, Whitaker won the vast majority of the rounds, and right now, Sweet Pea, as they call him here in Norfolk, is putting on the NABF belt with the help of his manager, Lou Duva. Alex Wallow standing by, waiting for that belt to be applied to Whitaker's midsection. Remember, coming up tape of Hagler Hearns. First time ever on over-the-air network television. Live interview with Marvelous Marvin Hagler, looking back at that fight and looking ahead to Hagler Leonard to take place April 6th. And Whitaker stands by with Alex Wallow right now.
Can you clear the way a little bit?
Take it away, Alex.
Was there never a doubt?
We're fixing to come.
No doubt. I mean, we know he didn't want to come in here and lay down. I mean, everybody's going to be up for Olympic champion. You know, you can expect that. You know, and you can, if you seen in there, sometimes I heard them, but I didn't. I kept my composure, and I showed the people that I can go 12 rounds.
You told me yesterday you were going to knock him out with a right hook. In that first round, you hurt him pretty good with the right hook.
Yeah, but Roger's a tough fighter, and I always had to be alert. You know, as you can see, he got a good right hand, and I had to utilize it by sometimes standing in front of him and sometimes moving around the side.
More body punching than we've seen from you recently. It seemed like the body punching in the first round set up the right hook.
Well, I worked hard, Alex. I worked on throwing a lot of punches, and as you can see, I wasn't worried about the distance. I just wanted to prove to Lou and the rest of my camp that I can do it, and I done it.
Pete, in the middle rounds, round six, round seven, you looked a little bit tired. You had him hurt a little once, and you let him get off the hook a little bit.
Well, you can't go 12 rounds straight or four. You have to be a professional and catch the second win. And that's what I done. I mean, I never let him get control of the rounds. I still kept control of the rounds, but I just wanted to put my punches together and not look sluggish.
Any problems with the left hand? I talked to you in between rounds.
No problem. 100%. Bring on anybody.
Congratulations on your first belt.
I'm going to be even better than this time. The next time's going to be even better.
Thanks, Pete.
All right. So that wraps up the victorious performance for Pernell Sweet Pea Whitaker as he remains unbeaten as a professional and looks forward to new horizons. We'll be back.
From one memorable fight.